try.
And if you like what you see, turn off the TV and do it.
Most people decided they couldn't draw at about the age of eight, between eight and about 10. And it was right when they realized they couldn't draw a nose or hands. Those are the two things that make people think, oh, I can't draw. And then they think they're washed up. But if you think about comics, if you think about like Bart Simpson with a hyper-realistic nose or hyper-realistic hands, that'd be horrible, right? I'm always interested in walking people back into drawing, but sort of unhitching it from having to pull the wagon of art, but more as drawing as this way of thinking. So this idea of faces, for example, human beings have evolved with a lot of sort of instincts, and one of them is to recognize upright faces. We even recognize faces that aren't faces. It's called pareidolia. We're gonna do just some sort of hairdo. So a common hairdo, I don't know, in the 1960s this was a real common hairdo. You can just do a common hairdo like that. But hair can also just be sort of scribbled. All right, now we come to the part of the face that people flip out about, which is the nose. But anything that's in the nose position is gonna read as a nose. Write a letter of the alphabet as in the nose area. Sort of punctuation mark or hashtag or at sign, some kind of thing. I'm gonna do a hashtag. Draw some little object. I don't know what it might be. And then some little scribble mark. So eyes, normally people make them sort of almond shaped. It's like a basic human eye. But eyes can also be really big. Put them anywhere you want. So just make a variety of eyes. Mouth. So a traditional way of doing a mouth, especially a girl's mouth, you know, we've got the lips with that Cupid's bow at the top, and that's like a standard mouth. But mouths can also be this, just a wiggly line. They can be little, whoa! But make any kind of mouth you want. The eyebrow. The eyebrow is the cartoonist's trick. So we can see that this woman here has her teeth and stuff, but she has sort of a bland look in her eyes. But guess what? She hates you. Once somebody knows how to draw really well, what that usually means is they know what not to draw, because they can't draw that. So they're, in a funny way, they're stuck. But people who are just beginning, they have no idea what they can and can't draw. And that's why I like to have them sitting side by side with each other, because it's the people that gave up on drawing that bring the most lively line to the class, and it's a huge help for the people who can draw.